tonight. Hey, good evening, everyone. We are on the record. I'm taking out my phone. The time is actually 6:20 p.m.
Yes.
I've just silenced it. I hope you all do the same. At 6:20 p.m., let me just say that this is a regular meeting of the Jersey City Municipal Council. Today is Wednesday, the 10th day of April in the year 2013. We had a scheduled 6 p.m. start at 6:20. Present at roll call, Councilman Sotolano. Councilman Donnelly.
Present.
Councilwoman Lopez.
Present.
Councilman Gaughan.
Present.
Councilman Fulop.
Here.
Councilwoman Coleman.
Here.
Councilman Lavaro.
Here.
Councilwoman Richardson.
Present.
Council President.
Yeah.
We have a 9-0. We have all nine members in attendance. Would everyone kindly rise to observe a moment of silence?
Marie Darling, she was the assistant to the pastor of the Lady of Mercy for a number of years. She passed away after a difficult battle with cancer.
Louise Paluzzi, OLM. Paparula Sr., Neil Fagan, and John Mayo Jr.
All right, council members, we have first reading ordinances. Permit me to read those into the record so I can get a little rhythm, and then I'll ask you to, after the first reading ordinances, to add certain items to the agenda, because I think we're going to have a little bit of a discussion about adding additional items, okay? Item 3A, City Ordinance 13039, is an ordinance of the Municipal Council of the City of Jersey City amending the 9th and Brunswick Redevelopment Plan. 3B is City Ordinance 13042, an ordinance of the Municipal Council of the City of Jersey City adopting amendments to the Bright Street Redevelopment Plan. 3C is City Ordinance 13043, an ordinance authorizing the City of Jersey City as lessee to extend a fourth amended lease agreement with 115 CCD Partners as lessor for office space at 115 Christopher Columbus Drive, Jersey City. 3D is City Ordinance 13044, an ordinance supplementing Chapter 332, Vehicles and Traffic, Article 3, Parking, Standing, and Stopping, amending Section 332-22, parking prohibited at all times of the Jersey City Code, designating no parking anytime on the north side of Theodore Conrad Drive, beginning 325 feet east of Edward Hart Road and extending clockwise to the south side of Theodore Conrad Drive to a point 325 feet east of Edward Hart Road. 3E is a franchise ordinance granting permission to Abdel Amin, his successors and assigns, to make private improvements to the public right-of-way at the property located at 60 Sussex Street, also known as 67 Green Street, Jersey City, New Jersey, also known on the tax maps of the City of Jersey City as Block 14304, Lot 5. 3F is an ordinance granting permission to 593 Jersey Avenue, LLC, its successors and assigns, to make private improvements in the Jersey Avenue public right-of-way adjacent to the property located at 591 Jersey Avenue, Jersey City, New Jersey, also known on the tax maps of the City of Jersey City as Block 11103, Lot 17, formerly known as Block 315, Lot A. 3G is City Ordinance 13047. It's an ordinance establishing Chapter 37, Immigrants Affairs Commission of the Jersey City Code. And 3H is ordinance 13048, an ordinance dedicating at the intersection of Woodward Street and Communipore Avenue, also be known as Bishop Canaan Wadsworth Johnson Way.
Robert, a motion to add item 3H, ordinance 13048, to the agenda.
Second. Okay. Thank you, Councilman. We have a motion by Councilman Gaughan, seconded by Councilman Sadolano, to add 3H to the agenda. Councilman Sadolano?
Aye.
Councilman Donnelly?
Aye.
Councilwoman Lopez?
Aye.
Councilman Gaughan?
Aye.
Councilman Fulop?
Stephen?
Aye.
Councilwoman Coleman?
Aye.
Councilman Lavaro?
Aye.
Councilwoman Richardson?
Aye.
Council President?
Aye.
Okay, council members, then permit me then to take a vote on 3A through 3H.
Motion to add resolutions.
Well, no, we have to have a substantial conversation about other resolutions, too, and I wanted to.
Okay.
Being there's no second reading ordinance, we're going to have a dialogue in a second. Okay, 3A through 3H. This is for first reading ordinances, 3A through 3H. Councilman Sadolano?
Aye.
Councilman Donnelly?
Aye for introduction.
Councilwoman Lopez?
Aye.
Councilman Gaughan?
Aye.
Councilman Fulop?
Aye.
Councilwoman Coleman?
Aye.
Councilman Lavaro?
This is for 3A through what?
3H.
Can I just go back? 3A through H. I just wanted to make a comment. I spoke on the 9th Street one to the developer here who, I mean, there are some concerns specifically on the sewer system that we spoke about, and you guys are going to talk to some of the people in the community in any way to accommodate that. So between now and 2 weeks, hopefully we'll get a resolution. And I think there's some concerns on the Bright Street as well regarding Van Voorst Park. And it's just a first reading, so hopefully you can communicate with the nine of us between now and then. And if it's not accommodating you, obviously we'll revisit at the second reading. So I just wanted to say that before voting aye on all.
Back to you, Councilman Lavaro.
I'm voting no on 3A and aye on all the rest.
Councilwoman Richardson? Council President?
Aye on all.
Now, council members, you did get a replacement for 3A that has the language in it that the council did ask for.
3A.
Council members, we have on the printed agenda a resolution 10Y. It was prepared earlier in the day and amended by Joanne Monahan. It now reads 10Y, does not read the way it reads on the title on the agenda. It is a resolution authorizing Community National Bank to prepare a joint application with the City of Jersey City, requesting the New Jersey Department of Banking and Insurance to establish a bank development district in the Martin Luther King Jr. Hub Plaza neighborhood.
Well, this is something that I've been working on for some time. I spoke with Senator Cunningham, and she took it to the state. They got a legislation that would allow us to do a banking district so that we will be able to put a bank in places like Martin Luther King Drive. The problem that I see right now with the resolution is it's not a part of a the spending plan that we get from the other banks. They're not listed.
Cash management.
It's not a part of the cash management. So unless we introduce the cash management ordinance, then we won't be able to do anything with this.
That be an ordinance or a resolution?
No, it's a resolution.
Resolution.
And council members, that That I would pass around right now, if you would just be kind enough to write Z1 on your copies. This would be Z1. This would be council members, this would be 10Z1. I'll read the title into the record. Well, 10Z, proposed by Councilman Donnelly, is a resolution opposing any privatization of the teacher aid positions in the Jersey City Public School District.
Actually, Robert, it was put together both by Councilman Fulop and myself, actually, just so.
Well, you handed it to me. I didn't know who the co-sponsor was. I didn't say anything.
I apologize.
I wouldn't say that.
Okay. Okay. NZ1, council members, is a resolution adopting the calendar year 2013 cash management plan for the city of Jersey City.
Motion for that, Robert?
Well, let me just catch up here, because I need a motion to add not only that.
Community National Bank.
What? We had X at the agenda at the caucus meeting.
All right.
What doesn't the bank?
Oh, no. We need to add X through Z1 to the agenda. Did I have a motion to do that?
X, 10Y, 10Z, and 10Z1. Second.
We have a motion to add 10X through 10Z1 to the agenda. Councilman Gorhan made the motion, seconded by Councilman Sadolano. To add these items to the agenda, Councilman Sadolano?
Aye.
Councilman Donnelly?
Aye.
Councilwoman Lopez?
Aye.
Councilman Gorhan?
Aye.
Councilman Fulop?
Aye.
Councilwoman Coleman?
Aye.
Councilman Lavaro?
Aye.
Councilwoman Richardson?
Aye.
Council President Brennan?
Aye.
All right, we will deal with these items later on. They are part of our agenda, X through Z1. Could I ask Mr. Kakaleski, did you talk to Ms. Donna about the local finance board meeting today?
Yes, and it's been approved.
Okay. Council members, there was, and I have another item agenda. For you.
Table agenda. Right.
We tabled this ordinance at the last meeting because it has not yet been approved by the New Jersey Local Finance Board.
11Z8.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Robert, I'll make that motion, 10Z8, to be removed from
the table. I just want to give everyone a copy.
11Z8,
Robert. Thank you.
I'll second it.
When I get to my seat, I'll write it down.
You feel like working as a team tonight.
You're the closer. Right.
Yeah.
Related.
Bring in the right hand.
All right, we have a motion by Councilman Gorhan. Seconded by Councilman Sadolano. I'm sorry, Councilwoman. He did that while I was distributing the item. 11Z8 is on the tabled agenda. It is City Ordinance 13031. It's an ordinance of the City of Jersey City and the County of Hudson, New Jersey, providing for the for various capital improvements for the City of Jersey City and appropriating $10,400,000 therefore, and providing for the issuance of $10,400,000 in general improvement bonds or notes of the City of Jersey City to finance the same. On the motion to add this to the to take this off the tabled agenda.
Sotolondo.
Councilman Sotolondo.
Aye.
Councilman Donnelly.
Aye.
Councilwoman Lopez.
Aye.
Councilman Gohan.
Aye.
Councilman Fulop.
Aye.
Councilwoman Coleman.
Aye.
Councilman Lavaro.
Aye.
Councilwoman Richardson.
Aye.
Council President.
Aye.
Okay. Now, council members, there are no first readings, second reading ordinances on the agenda. Now there will be, given that this has been taken off the tabled agenda. This ordinance was introduced on March 13th. We held a public hearing on March 28th. So now it would be in order to consider the final adoption of City Ordinance 13031, an ordinance of the City of Jersey City and the County of Hudson, New Jersey, providing for various capital improvements for the City of Jersey City and appropriating $10,400,000 therefore, and providing for the issuance of $10,400,000 in general improvement bonds or notes of the City of Jersey City to finance the same. For the final adoption of this ordinance, Councilman Sotolondo.
This was tabled after public hearing.
Tabled after the public hearing. Thank you. Councilman Donnelly.
Aye.
Councilwoman Lopez.
Aye.
Councilman Gohan.
Aye.
Councilman Fulop.
Aye.
Councilwoman Coleman.
Aye.
Councilman Lavaro.
Aye.
Councilwoman Richardson.
Aye.
Council President Brennan.
Aye.
We have a 9-0 vote for the final adoption of City Ordinance 13031. It'll become item 4A on tonight's agenda, having been removed from the tabled agenda. All right. Council members, if I could ask for, this is an off night for the clerk, as I guess you can all tell so far. I had Ms. Laverne Washington indicate that she called my office to be listed on the speaker's list, and it when she does call, it's very early, after usually the day after a council meeting. So I would ask if, just as a point of privilege, if we could just permit her to be placed on the list early in the list so that she could speak, if that's okay with the council.
Come up, Laverne.
All right, Laverne. I do want you to get the name of the people that you give your name to, please. Or ask for me.
And yes,
then
sir.
Then I'll punish myself.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. First of all, I don't come to this council meeting to get on TV. I've been coming to Jersey City Council meetings before they redid this council. I've been coming since Smith was a city clerk, and before that, when Gann Jimmy was mayor. I've been in this city for 65 years, and I don't need no one to tell me when I get up here to speak that I come here to get on TV. I don't even want to be in the Jersey General, more or less on the television. I come here for my community, the children in my community, the seniors, people looking for houses and for jobs that ring my phone. So I don't have to come here to be on no TV. And the next thing I come here about tonight, the company on Communipore Avenue, Ideal Supplies, they help us in this community for years.
They do the piping for big buildings like they're building up downtown. I have the man's card. His piping is American-made piping. That company has been on Communipore Avenue between Garfield and Madden Avenue since 1930. In the same place in our community, and that plant needs business from Jersey City. When these developers come up here, these people getting abatements, I got the gentleman's card that runs the company. It would be nice because he's a very supporter to the children of our community. And not what if the city of Jersey City, he supports down there for the kids for baseball, boxing, swimming, whatever. But Don is a very good man. He runs a business there where people live here in our city, work at his company. So I bought his cards. So you guys can pass them out to people that's coming here, getting abatements, that building these big 45-story buildings, so we can continue to help people with jobs in the city. And the second thing is, I'm very upset about, is that people keep talking about crime in my city. When I came to this council meeting back in September, when the young man got killed on Randolph and Harmon Street, when I had to wash part of his brains up off my sidewalk, nobody showed up at my council, at my community meetings twice. Twice I had. The only one showed up, our council president, our council at large, and then you wasn't here, Ms. Coleman, it was Ms. Massey. But I gave everybody stuff about the meetings. The chief of police was represented, the mayor was represented, Mr. Cabilli came. And, you know, I'm appalled that people can say and continue to target Ward F as this big crime. My nephew lives in Jordan Square. I put him with my great nephew. I put him on a plane yesterday morning to Florida to a rehab. Because up there on Summit Plaza and up there by Pershing Fields, where they be smoking blunts and stuff and gang banging up there, I had to get him out of town. So, you know, this stuff I fight from up here in the Heights, Queens to City Line. And this thing is not a Jersey City or New Jersey thing. It's in Georgia, it's in Florida, it's in California, it's across America. You know, so, you know, we need to focus on bringing all our major urban cities together. So all this fighting and all this negative elections coming in May, and all that I can get in my mailbox is a bunch of garbage. You know, we need to focus on doing better. This council, this city needs to focus on doing better. I've been up here fighting for about 15 years. For community stuff for these children. It ain't got nothing to do with nobody up here now, up down here, because it's been a long time. See, Mayor Schindler took and built a charter school downtown when we were supposed to, back then, get Webb Park done. See, I was at them caucuses. See, people don't talk, but everybody all of a sudden is, everything happened yesterday. This just didn't start yesterday, people. It been started. This fight ain't just started. Like I said, I've been coming this council meeting before half of y'all was even living in Jersey are born here. So, you know, it's a thing now that we all come together. We all here. We all here. And we all got to represent the city. I don't care what ward you live in. You sit up there, you represent this whole city of Jersey City. And we need to focus on that. Stop all this mess. Because I rode down MLK yesterday with tears in my eyes to see our young people. And I rode from McAdoo clean to McGinley Square. Then I rode Ocean Avenue. I rode Burgundy Avenue. I rode up here. You know, get in your car on a nice day and see what's going on in our city. It ain't one spot. Stop targeting Ward F. This is a city thing. And we all need to stop that. And let's get together, because we all, you know, Mitt Romney tried to buy the White House, but God moved and put Obama back there. So money don't buy everything.
Laverne.
Yes, ma'am.
I just like to let you know that I was riding up all those avenues with you yesterday, and it took me 25 minutes to get from Communipore Avenue
to Bayview Avenue because of the traffic that was out there. So you are absolutely right. They need to find something for them to do.
And we got a debate tomorrow at Lincoln High School. I'd like to see everybody there, too.
Thank you, Laverne.
Thank you,
Thank Hey, Lois Garvin. Is Lois Garvin present?
Bless you.
Thank you.
Bless you.
Thank you.
I live in Jersey City. I own a house there for 25 years. I've worked for the United States Postal Service for 34 years and had to leave because of medical problems. All these are my medical problems. I'm struggling. United Water comes in my house and says, I didn't want to let them in because they said it was a problem. I said, I don't have a problem with my sewer or my water. They came and said, you have a leak. Your porch might fall. I'm up here having a heart attack thinking I'm going to hurt somebody. They sent me, said I had 3 days to repair this. I went crying to certain people to try to get this corrected because I got a plumber. The plumber said there was no leak. I have it in writing. I called my insurance company. My insurance company said, there is no leak. They took pictures, there is no leak. Where, how can they determine there's a leak? I said, United Water says there's a leak and my porch can cave in, I can hurt somebody else's property and I'm responsible. United, MUA gave me an extension to try to resolve because it would cost me $7,000 to $10,000 to do this work in 3 days. I don't have that kind of money, I'm struggling. United Water comes back to my door and says to me, you have a leak. I said, could you tell me where it is then? Because it's not in the building. Out there. Out there where? You got the Urban League, you got a church beside me, but it's me. How is me? How do you determine it's me? And in the meanwhile, they want me to, if I don't have it done, they're going to excavate, they're going to charge me $3,250 and the